Yeah, let us discuss about universal set. What is universal set? The set containing all the objects or all the elements and of which all other sets are subsets to this. So, what we can say, universal set is nothing but the set containing all objects and other all other sets are subset to this set. That is called as the universal set. For example, suppose you have a set P, that is set of even integers. And you have another set of odd integers. Then you have another set of integers. So set of integers is the universal set for these both sets. For these both sets, universal set is set of integers. Like I just want to say, even integers means what? Even integers means 0, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 4, plus or minus 6, plus or minus 8. These are even integers. And odd integers means what? What is the odd integers? Plus or minus 1, plus or minus 3, plus or minus 5. These are odd integers till infinity. What is the universal set here? Integer means what? Minus infinity to minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. All these are there. This is an integer. So this is a universal set because these two sets are subset to this set, and according to this collection, this is called the universal set. A set which is containing all elements, that is called universal set. Hope you understand this is universal set. Okay, now let us discuss some more points on this. Difference of sets. Let us take difference of the sets. The operation number 3. A is equal to, you have a set 1, 2, 3. B is equal to, you have a set 4, 5, 6. Then another set 3 is equal to 2, 3, 7, 8. Let us take like this. And D is equal to, I can take 1, 2, 3. Now I will discuss about difference of the sets. The first one is, let us discuss A minus B. What is A minus B? Write the first set 1, 2, 3 minus. Write the second set 4, 5, 6. What is the difference of the sets? Now see here, what is common in both? Nothing is common. So you cannot cancel. So what is left in the first set? That is the difference of the sets. 1, 2, 3. This is the difference of the sets. Now let us go for another example. A minus C I want to do. What is A here? 1, 2, 3. Minus. What is B here? 2, 3, 7, 8. Now difference of this set will be, let us cancel the same point where they are common. What is left in the first set? Remember this. What is left in the first set? That is the difference of the sets. 1 is the answer. A minus C is 1. Not 1, 7, 8. This is 1. If I write this is C minus A, what I write here, C is 2, 3, 7, 8. Minus 1, 2, 3. If I do subtraction, see here, 2 gets cancelled, 3 gets cancelled. What is remaining in the first set? That is the difference of the set, 7, 8. These all things you will understand when I am explaining the Venn diagrams. Okay? You will understand clear picture in the Venn diagrams. So these are the operations. Okay, operations. Now let us go for A minus D. A minus D is A is what? 1, 2, 3. Minus. D is what here? 1, 2, 3. Then you can cancel here. 1, 2, 3. All cancel. Answer is null set. Empty set. So A minus D is empty set. Suppose you are doing A minus 5. A is, suppose, what is A here? 1, 2, 3 and pi is null set. If I am doing subtraction of this both, there is no subtraction. So 1, 2, 3, answer is A itself. So you just notice these things. You should know these operations. So this is the difference of the sets and this is the operation on this. Hope you understand now. Now complement of A. Let us discuss about complement of A. Let us discuss. A is nothing but complement of the set. This is the last operation. Complement of A. Let us discuss the complement of A. Complement of A denoted by A dash or A complement symbol. is called as complement of the set. For example, there is a set A is equal to, let us discuss 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is a universal set. Let us consider a set. And another set A is equal to 2, 4, 6, 8. And B is equal to, you have 1, 3, 5, 7. You have like this, suppose. For example, just I'm taking. Now I want to find what is A complement. A complement is equal to nothing but universal set represented by two ways. Universal set represented by U or universal set represented by U. This is also that. So if you are representing U, okay, you represent, otherwise mu also you can represent. A complement is equal to formula is universal set minus A. What is the universal set here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 minus, what is A here? 2, 4, 6, 8. Now, if I do subtraction, 2, 2, 4, 4, 6, 6, 8, 8. In general, we don't cancel like this. There is no cancellation like this. To make you understand, I am cancelling. What is left in this? 1, 3, 5, 7. You should not cancel like this. In general, you need to think on this. And what is, remember, you should write, this is called as A complement. This is called as A complement. A complement. Complement is this. For example, I just state you, Venn diagrams will be represented by rectangle or square representation. Rectangle or square. Universal set is whole by collection. This is the universal set. Let us take one set is a circle shape, A set. This is A set. A is containing elements are 2, 4, 6, 8 here. The rest of the universal set has the elements 1. You can write anywhere in the circle, members. You can write anywhere in the circle. You can write the rest of the elements also anywhere. 1, 3, 5. Just I am explaining to you. I'll come back again. So 1, 3, 5, 7. These are outside of this. So universal set is nothing but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. But A set is what? What is A set? 2, 4, 6, 8. Whenever I am saying A complement, means without A everything. Without A everything. Whatever thing is there, without A, that is called as complement of A. Complement of A is no A. No A. Without A, remaining thing will be complement of A. This is the operation of complement. Hope you understand the complement rule. So just let us see here. A. What is phi complement? What is the complement of phi? This is most important. What is the complement of phi? That is mu minus phi. Mu minus phi. And according to the rule, mu, any complement is there, then universal set minus A. So phi complement is there, universal set minus phi. Universal set, that is whole the set, and minus phi is universal set itself. You will get universal set. So universal pi complement is a universal set. Remember that pi complement is a universal set. If I say universal set complement, that is universal set minus universal set, that is pi. So complement of universal set is pi. Complement of pi is universal set. This is one more thing you should remember. Okay, let me explain detail in future about these things. Let us discuss about the Venn diagrams to make you understand here this operations. And this is most important thing is to learn the Venn diagrams. Main thing is learning Venn diagrams. Reason is, these Venn diagrams in probability, in permutation combination will use more. So you should know Venn diagrams. Okay. So John Venn, in some 18th century, he has introduced the Venn diagrams. What happened here? They first of all introduced in the this way. They considered the sets in this way. They considered in this way. After that, this is modified and converted into a set in the circular form. Represented a set in the circular form. The universal set they consider as a rectangle box or a square box. They consider it is a rectangle box or square box. You can take it is a square box also, no problem. So universal set they consider as this one, either rectangle square box, either it is a rectangular box. And the concept in two sets like that. So we'll discuss in depth in the next lecture, that is what is the Venn diagram and how to draw the Venn diagram. This is most important. Main concept starts from now. Operations are the basic concepts of the sets. Hope you understand. If you already learned in the class 10 or 9 in course, that's okay, fine, but I have to repeat here again to make you understand. Whether you have learned in from different schools and you are coming here, you should know, understand everything. So I am covering this topic. In 2-3 days I will finish this topic, then I will start the quadratic equation or matrices and determinants. Okay. Hope